of Japan's greatest ever cinematic auteurs. In 1970, the visionary Akira Kurosawa would take the plunge from black and white cinema into the world of color. Largely underrated in the scope of his monumental career, Kurosawa's color works don't quite receive the same consideration as his black and white films. In order to understand why this is the case, we must first look at the purpose of color in a Kurosawa film and determine precisely why this change in style was more than a mere adapting with the times. You see, Kurosawa wanted to master color theory. Much like how a painter would use colors, he painted his own storyboards, and much of these storyboards would go on to match their respective shots impeccably. But perhaps where Kurosawa stands out amongst his fellow directors is his decision to use color as a storytelling device itself. Akira Kurosawa's sprawling and epic take on the story of King Lear is one of cinema's most impressive achievements. In Ran, he builds slowly until the on-screen eventual chaos finally unfolds. But the term chaos, which is Japanese for Ran, isn't just in relation to the events that unfold, but it represents the inner turmoil for the film's characters. Tatsuya Nakadai is the embodiment of this. One can't help but feel isolated and abandoned when watching the fall of his character into eventual disarray. Warm colors were used by Kurosawa here to emphasize danger and passion. He also uses color to depict the personality of his characters, conditions, and their feelings. Ran has a certain theatricality to it. This is also a reason for the film's color palette and its over-stylized nature. These elements are what give the film its scope-driven style and what add to the film's overall spectacle and visual majesty. Once again, this scene allows us to understand why Kurosawa's bright and vivid colors work as he offers them up in stark contrast to the bleak tragedy that unfolds on screen. Kurosawa maintains these colors throughout the film, for without this color coding, allowing us to distinguish each army during the many scope-driven battle sequences. Kurosawa's choice to use color as a storytelling device extends to the film's impressive battle sequences. Kurosawa's use of color to identify the vivid uniforms, flags, and military bases allow the viewer to keep track of the characters in each of the bold yellow, red, and blue uniforms. This choice is a specific one, and we can notice this by the fact that red, yellow, and blue are all primary colors. Each army is distinguishable by a stark and bold color. For instance, in this iconic scene, we witness Hitora emerging from his castle now ravaged and destroyed by defeat. His skin is white, representing the color one would associate with a ghostly entity. The two boldly colored fighting armies have now left him there. He is now the lone void in this colored fusion. For the colors have engulfed him, all while they surround him, further emphasizing the destruction of this family, a result of betrayal, greed, and the inevitable hunger for power.